Testing. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Linda Medley, and I am just the proud principal of Flower Bluff High School. I want to welcome all of you this evening to the commencement ceremony for the Flower Bluff High School graduating class of 2023. We are grateful that you all have joined us on this special occasion. At this time, I'd like to ask that you please turn off or silence all cell phones and electronic devices. If you're still standing, if you can please try and find your seat, because we know everyone wants to see their graduates this evening. Please remain seated as our class of 2023 graduates enter the arena. Thank you. say a few words to calm him down.
Yes, ma'am.
And you can stand right up here next to me, and then you'll get started.
Thank you.
We'll wait till the readers get on there.
Right.
And it looks like our singers are coming up here, too, so we'll wait for them. Wow. This is going to be our graduating class of 2023. And before we get started, I just have to say this class wanted to start new things this year. And one of the things they did was they set the bar pretty high because they're our largest class. We're graduating almost over 100 seniors than what we did last year. So kudos to you guys and parents. That's a huge accomplishment. Okay, you want to go ahead?
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of colors and remain standing for the national anthem and the invocation. The colors are being presented by Flower Bluff High School NJROTC Honor Guard Hannah Holbrooks, Isabella Perez, John Paul Hurtado, and Isabella Skinner. The national anthem will be sung by Paige Dwyer, Abigail Wingington, and Agnes Garcia.
Allegard, Holtz, F, Ace, Reese, and Colors.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
Thank you. Please remain standing for the invocation. Today's invocation will be led by Julia Valesky.
Please bow your heads and join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for every student here tonight. We praise you for guiding every graduate through their studies and for granting us all the opportunity to celebrate the hard work and perseverance that each unique student exhibited during their time in high school. Thank you for keeping them safe and allowing them to share their accomplishments with friends and family. We pray that you bless this gathering and place your righteous hand over each and every one of these graduates as they continue their walk through life. May this ceremony glorify you and honor your presence and influence in the lives of everyone here today, because without you, none of this would be possible. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Thank you.
Thank you. You may now be seated.
Good evening. I'd like to formally welcome everyone here tonight. Graduates, parents, families, friends, and all Flower Bluff ISD staff. My name is Velma Solis Garcia, and I have the honor of leading this district as your superintendent. My team and I have so much in common with all of you here this evening. We have proudly mentored, counseled, and guided our class of 2023 graduates from young students into our future military, law enforcement, engineers, educators, medical professionals, college athletes, first responders, and so much more. We have watched this class persevere through a shutdown, online learning, and adversities that many of us could not imagine. Yet, you sit here in front of us today, all 456 graduates, stronger, wiser, and prepared to embark on your journey. I am confident that Flower Bluff ISD has inspired, fostered, and empowered you to be confident, productive members of society who will pursue excellence with the utmost integrity. To all of our families, thank you. Thank you for partnering with us. Most importantly, thank you for entrusting us with your children, our students. At this time, I would like to introduce our Board of Trustees. Without their countless hours of dedication to our students and staff, this evening would not be possible. I ask that each of you please stand and be recognized and remain standing until all members of your group have been introduced. Mrs. Shirley Thornton, President. Mr. Jerry Hooper, Jr., Vice President. Mrs. Jennifer Welp, Secretary. Mr. David Gerlach, Member. Mr. Michael Morgan, Member. Dr. Jim Needham, Member. Mrs. Jeannie Blankenship-Palucio, Member. Thank you. You may be seated. I would also like to recognize our Flower Bluff ISD administrative staff, Dr. Linda Bargansky, Associate Superintendent for Federal and State Programs, Mr. James Crenshaw, Associate Superintendent for Student Services, Ms. Nicole White, Executive Director of Curriculum and Instruction, Dr. Melanie Shandy, Director of Special Education, Mrs. Cindy Holder, Director of Hornet Learning Academy and Student Development and Guidance Center, and Ms. Stacy Cade, Coordinator of Assessment and Accountability. Thank you. You may be seated.
Without all of our staff, starting from our ECC campus all the way to the high school, we wouldn't be able to get here where we are today. All of our students, a lot of them started out with us at the ECC, and they've stayed with us, and some of them transferred over. And so at this time, I just want to acknowledge any Flower Bluff ISD faculty and staff who have joined us today. If you can just please take a stand. Yesterday, we were fortunate enough to be able to take our last senior walk, and we returned back to the campuses. These seniors could have chosen to stay at home, but they didn't. All of them showed up because they wanted to go back and tell their teachers thank you. So thank you so much for everything that you did and for pouring into our students. It's because of you that our graduates have received an unparalleled education. Thank you for the countless hours of devotion and hard work. On behalf of Flower Bluff ISD, we strongly feel that it's extremely important and appropriate for us to recognize the gift of freedom that we have in this country, so generously provided by our men and our women in military. I'm going to ask at this time any persons in the audience who have served or are currently serving our country, please stand. We have some seniors this year who have also made a commitment to serve our country. So class of 2023 seniors, if you have enlisted in the military, please stand and be recognized at this time. Thank you so much for the sacrifices you and your families are making to ensure that freedoms that we enjoy today are free. Thank you so much. At this time, it is my honor to introduce our commencement speaker, Dr. Mackenzie Thompson. She was a student here not too long ago, so some of you may know her as Mackenzie Spaniel. She's a Flower Bluff High School class of 2011 alumna who grew up on the island, and she attended Flower Bluff ISD since sixth grade. During her time at Flower Bluff High School, Dr. Thompson was an active member of several organizations, including varsity track and golf, and she proudly served as the mascot, Buzzy the Hornet. After graduation, she pursued higher education at the University of Texas at Austin. With a passion for health sciences and medical ethics, Dr. Thompson obtained a Bachelor of Science with honors in advanced nutritional sciences with a minor in medical ethics and religion. Dr. Thompson earned a Doctor of Medicine and a Master of Public Health from the University of Texas Health Science Center in San Antonio, Texas. Currently, Dr. Thompson works as an emergency medicine physician in Austin, Texas. She serves as a shining example of what can be achieved through hard work, dedication, and a passion for helping others. And just like you graduates, her mom flew all the way here just to see her speak. So please join me in welcoming Dr. Mackenzie Thompson.
Good evening, graduates, parents, teachers, and special guests. I am humbled to be standing before you today on a day of such success to talk about failure. You may be thinking, why would she choose to talk about the exact opposite of what this day is all about? I hear you, and I hope that in the end, I can convince you that you can't have a life of success without failing along the way. As you sit here today, you have accomplished an incredible feat. You've completed high school, and you should all be proud of yourselves. But as you move forward in life, you will undoubtedly encounter failure. Failure is inevitable. It's part of the human experience, but it's how we respond to failure that shapes us and defines us. Many of us have been taught that failure is something to be ashamed of, that it means we're not good enough or we're not capable of succeeding, but this couldn't be further from the truth. Failure is not a reflection of your worth or your abilities. Failure is simply an opportunity to learn and to grow. Coach Steinbrook, more than anyone, taught me this. After each track meet, we would review each detail of how I could adjust and become better for the next week. I never won first place, and I never went to state, but I learned an invaluable lesson, how to embrace failure as an opportunity. As a society, we've become so focused on success that we've forgotten the importance of failure. We've created a culture where failure is seen as a weakness and a source of shame, but this mindset is flawed. Failure is not the opposite of success, but rather a necessary step on the path to success. The truth is, we learn a lot more from our failures than we do from our successes. It is through failure that we gain new perspectives, new insights, and new knowledge. It is through failure that we develop resilience, perseverance, and grit. But in order to learn from failure, we must adopt a growth mindset. A growth mindset is the belief that our abilities and intelligence can develop through hard work, dedication, and persistence. It is the belief that failure is not a sign of weakness, but an opportunity for growth. A growth mindset allows us to embrace failure and learn from it. It allows us to see challenges as opportunities and setbacks as temporary. It allows us to push through adversity and come out stronger on the other side. I've made many wrong decisions. I've failed many tests. I've had many doors slammed in my face. And for this, I am stronger. I am proud of who I am today, and it all started as I sat in your seat 12 years ago. So as you embark on this new chapter in your life, I ask one thing of you. Do not be afraid of the word no, but instead fear missing an opportunity that you preemptively stifled by accepting no for an answer. The truth is, you will all receive an email that starts, "Thank you for your application, but I regret to inform you, we've chosen someone else." You will all sit in 100 interviews for jobs you will never get. You will all hear more no's in your life than you will hear yeses. It is not the moment of no that defines you, but rather the moments after when you choose how to respond that determine your future. Embrace the word no. Embrace failure. Use it to fuel the flame of your aspirations. Remember that failure is not something to be ashamed of, but an opportunity to learn and to grow. Remember that success is not the absence of failure, but the ability to learn from it and use it as a stepping stone to greatness. So in conclusion, I want to leave you with a quote from the great Michael Jordan. He said this, "I've missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I've been trusted to make the game-winning shot, and I've missed. I've failed over and over and over again in my life, and that is why I succeed." Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2023.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Lucas Trasudis.
And my name is Anne Christabel Martin. Lucas, did you think about our height difference before signing up for the welcoming address?
No, not really. Not until now, seeing that we're going to have to constantly adjust the mic.
Anyways, Lucas, have you ever watched any stereotypical high school movie, like Mean Girls, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, or High School Musical?
Oh. High School Musical.
So, assuming that you have watched it, on a scale of 1 to 10, how similar was your high school experience to the movie High School Musical?
Okay, now we're talking. I would say it was very similar. There wasn't a single day where the students didn't break out into singing and dancing in the cafeteria or do kick lines down the hallway. And how could I forget singing Get Your Head in the Game before every basketball game? So overall, I would say a 2.
A 2? Well, I guess we had very different experiences.
Despite the differences between High School Musical and our high school experience at Flower Bluff, it is easy to say that through great trials and tribulations, we are all in this together.
Whether we went through online schooling because of COVID, countless power outages, and random fire drills, we were able to bop, 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 bop to the top. Good evening, and welcome to the Flower Bluff Class of 2023 graduation ceremony. We would like to welcome the administration, faculty, board members, friends, family, and the class of 2023.
Let's all take a second to look around and see where we are at. Every individual sitting here today has come from different backgrounds, have different beliefs, and different goals. However, something similar between us all is that we each worked hard to get where we are today.
Out of one universe, 8 planets, 195 countries, 1,864 islands, 7 seas, and 8 billion people, we have all somehow made our way to this graduation ceremony. It's crazy to think about it, right?
This ceremony will definitely go by fast, but do not worry, because this moment isn't the end of our stories. Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
Each individual here is capable of making a positive difference in someone's life. Although we are not aware, there is an infinite domino effect of individuals making a difference in the world today. It is time for us to join this domino effect, not tomorrow or the next day, but today, this moment right now.
There truly is no stopping in what we can do. because together we are already taking the first few steps to changing the world. Thank you all,
and enjoy the class of 2023 graduation ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you Michaela Jordan. Michaela Jordan has worked very hard, and so I'm going to present her with a plaque honoring her as the class of 2023 Flower Bluff High School salutatorian. But before I do that, I'd just like to recognize the parents of Michaela. Wherever you are, can you please stand? They're in the back. They came prepared with signs. Thank you for helping her.
Good evening. I'm Michaela Jordan, the Flower Bluff Class of 2023 salutatorian, and today is May 25th. So far, plenty of important events have already happened on May 25th. Charles de Gaulle became the Prime Minister of France on May 25th, 1958. Star Wars: Return of the Jedi was released in the United States on May 25th, 1983. And today, May 25th, 2023, 456 students are graduating from Flower Bluff High School. I would like to thank each and every one of you who showed up today and who have helped us navigate through the dicey waters of high school. Getting through high school can really be a difficult journey. Not only are we trying to pass classes, keep up with extracurriculars, and try to get scholarships to avoid going into crippling debt, but we're also trying to make friends, find happiness, and make plans for our futures. The reason why I emphasize finding a balance between schoolwork and a personal life is because it's something that I realized I needed far too late. Up until my senior year, I spent probably 90% of my time focused on my school and grades and just worrying about all of that. Ultimately, I sacrificed time that I could have been spending with my family or doing other things that I love. I'm not standing here as salutatorian because I have everything figured out. Of course, nobody does. But I have figured out one very important lesson that I would like to share with you. And no, it has nothing to do with physics. While writing this speech, one question sat at the back of my mind. Was it worth it, 4 years of giving up my sleep, energy, and happiness to be at the top of my class? The answer is no, not really. I realized that I gave up a lot to be here. I gave up my free time and even my sanity on occasion. Sure, I am proud to stand here in front of you and share with you a few words of wisdom. But ultimately, my lesson here today is that you don't need to be the best at something to be important. For the longest time, I relied on my academic success to make me feel good about myself. Then I realized that equating my self-worth to my grades was wrong. I was so incredibly wrong. Yes, I did do well at calculus, anatomy, and biology. However, I realized that no matter how good I could be at something, someone is always going to be better. But this doesn't mean we shouldn't try our best. This just means that someone better is presenting us with a challenge. It's important that we don't quit when we're challenged by others, but we also shouldn't sacrifice our social lives trying to compete with them. We can't forget about the people or hobbies we love just to be the best. Instead of worrying about what others are doing or how good our friends are at calculus, we need to focus on our own well-being, our own skills, and our own efforts. Being the best at something doesn't make us good people. What makes us good people is treating others with kindness, respect, and most importantly, selflessness. What we hear about high school is true. It's a learning experience. And I don't just mean in terms of schoolwork. I learned the value of perseverance, not the Mars rover. To persevere means to push through the hard times and to get back up again when we falter. After all, life keeps going no matter what we're going through. Whether it's heartbreak or loss or failure, life goes on and we never know what our future holds for us. In the wise words of Master Yoda, we must unlearn what we have learned. We, the class of 2023, have turned what could have been failures into challenges that we have overcome in order to walk this stage today. Despite the obstacles we will face, we are all capable of doing great things. Just maybe one of us will cure cancer. Until then, we can do the small things that make a big difference. Our lives are not measured by the popularity of our accomplishments, but by the impact we've made on others. On that note, I would like to acknowledge the amazing people who have made an immense impact on me and my education. Thank you to my mom and dad for supporting me through the highs and the lows. I would also like to thank my teammates on Stingline, especially my best friend, for always being there for me. Thank you to my genius little brother for always humbling me and reminding me that I'm not the best at math. And thank you to all of my other family members for coming across the country or across the state to see me graduate. And although they can't understand me, I would also like to thank my two dogs, Coco and Storm, for helping me persevere by begging for my attention and always distracting me from the impending feeling of doom that schoolwork always seems to bring. Lastly, I would like to thank a few of the teachers who have made a difference in my education. Mr. Gillespie challenged me in geometry and strengthened my drive to try my best in everything I do. Mr. Gain taught me not only how to be a good student, but how to realize my value is not tied to my grades. Mrs. Huckabee challenged me in science class and never let me settle for good enough, because striving for knowledge is how we learn. I would also like to commend my math teacher for the past 2 years, Mr. Vallone, for making math seem easy by being such a great teacher. Lastly, I would like to thank Mrs. Shigoda. Although I was only in Mrs. Shigoda's class for one semester, I was challenged to my limits in literature, a subject I'm usually not confident in. Ms. Shigoda made me a better writer, but more importantly, she made an impact on my life by teaching me that getting perfect grades is not more important than my happiness. Finally, I would like to congratulate every single one of our graduates today. I would like to applaud you for making it through whatever obstacles life has thrown at you, whether it be retaking an SAT, dealing with friend group drama, or defending the galaxy from Darth Vader. Don't forget to take time for yourself, maybe destroy the Death Star. No matter what, make happy memories while you're doing it. Congratulations, graduates, we made it, and may the force be with you. Thank you for listening. Now I'll let you get on with your regularly scheduled graduation. This has been Michaela Jordan, class of 2023 salutatorian. Peace out.
Thank you, Michaela. It's a privilege this evening to introduce to you Carlos Doble, the valedictorian of our Flower Bluff High School senior class. I would like to present you with this plaque honoring you as our valedictorian. In addition, I'm also going to present you a scholarship certificate entitling you to free tuition for 1 year at any Texas public college or university. Would the parents of Carlos Doble please stand also and be recognized?
Good evening. Sorry. Good evening, everyone. As this year's valedictorian, it is my sworn duty to bore you all to death for the next 5 minutes. I can see some of you yawning already, so I think we're off to a good start. But in all seriousness, it really is a privilege for all of you to be here listening to me speak. What a treat. All right. I'd like to start off by thanking everyone who has played a part in getting us here today. To the administrators who strive to create the best possible learning environment in unprecedented times, all while reminding us that we matter, thank you. To the staff for keeping everything up and running, making Flower Bluff High School a wonderful place, thank you. To the teachers who answered our questions, pushed us to be our best selves, dealt with us when we were lazy and didn't want to do anything, and never left any students behind, thank you. To our parents and our families, you've earned this moment just as much as any of us have. Thank you for guiding us through our lives. We love you. For those who prefer it in Spanish, familia, gracias por siempre estar ahí por nosotros. Los amamos mucho. Again, to the parents out there, I know many of you are a little worried about sending your kids off into the adult world, but I just wanted to reassure you that you're right, you should definitely be worried. Even though we're all grown up, about to tackle the problems of the real world, most of us still couldn't stop ourselves from laughing while learning about the reproductive system in biology class. This is where our minds are right now, future doctors, lawyers, and engineers. The owner of the next Fortune 500 company may just be that guy who'd copy and paste 3 pages worth of Shrek memes onto the Google Doc where everyone else is trying to work. You guys know who you are. This is the future of America. But in reality, we all have so much to be proud of, and we are more than ready for the next step. I'd like to remind everyone of a commencement speech that a coach or a teacher may have made you listen to once or twice, or maybe 17 times. Thank you, Coach Pesek. In the speech, Navy SEAL Admiral William H. McRaven essentially says, "Make your bed every morning, and you will be set up to complete more small tasks throughout the day, leading you towards achieving bigger goals." I'll be honest with you, that's not happening. I don't see myself making my bed every morning, and I don't see most of you doing it either. What I will tell you is this: by graduating high school, we've just made the biggest, fluffiest beds of our lives, and we're set up to achieve anything we set our minds to. Now is the time where we take responsibility for our own lives and figure out how to achieve our goals. I speak to everyone sitting in front of me when I say, we can do it. I know we can, because we've already been through so much. Freshman year, COVID hit, and we all had to do school completely online. That was hard, and it was lonely, but we made it. And at the same time, many of us learned that we could simultaneously listen to the teacher while winning a game of Clash Royale, so if we can do that, what can't we do? Junior year, many of us had to travel long distances just to use the restroom because some people thought it was a good idea to steal a bathroom door or throw a urinal into the ceiling. And of course, this year, most of us were inevitably infected by the dangerous and widespread epidemic that is senioritis. We all know that feeling where it seems like doing just one more assignment is physically impossible, but we still made it. Shout out to my man Jared over there. He's had a bad case of senioritis for 4 straight years. Don't know how you did it, buddy. All that is to say, we've been tried and tested, pushed to our limits, but we're still here today. Because of this, I'm confident that every one of us in this room can set any goal, no matter how unrealistic or massive, and achieve it. With that being said, I want to leave you with this piece of advice. Don't make life all about the goals. Let me say it again. Do not focus your life solely on achieving your goals. Obviously, it's important to work hard and pursue your dreams, but at what cost? Take it from me. My ultimate goal in high school, since I realized it was possible, was to be the valedictorian. I worked hard, I studied, I made sacrifices, and I put in extra hours. And I did it. I'm standing here right now. The initial feeling of being called down to the front office and seeing my name in the number one spot was awesome. Everything I had been working towards for the past 4 years had culminated into one final victory. I felt amazing. For a few minutes. Before I knew it, I was back in Mr. Vallone's class, and all the buzz had faded away. The only thing I could think was, what now? I'm not sure what I was expecting. Maybe I thought achieving my goal would magically wipe away everything and leave me with eternal joy. Instead, I was the same person I was before. All the people around me were the same people they were before. All the mistakes I had made, all the challenges I was facing, were still right there. Then it clicked. Everything has a price. I paid for my success by neglecting some of the important relationships in my life. And that's a mistake, because those relationships in your life are more important than any goal. When you've achieved a goal, and it's all over, those relationships and those people are what's still there. So I did some self-reflecting, a lot actually, and I'd like to think that I learned my lesson. Now I'd like to ask you to reflect for a minute. And I know this may cause some discomfort, and maybe the last thing you want to do on your graduation day, but better you do it right now than 40 years from now when it's your family you've neglected and it's too late. So be honest. What are your biggest priorities in life? Who are the people you care about? Based on the way you treat them and the way you live, do these people know how much you care about them? Make sure you take good care of the people you love. Don't forget about the people who've been there for you in your life. It's never too late to fix a relationship, strengthen a good one, or start a new one. Maybe there's someone who you hurt. If so, just tell them you're sorry. Maybe there's someone you haven't spoken to in a while, and you miss them. Just call them up or reach out somehow. Or maybe you need to forgive someone. If so, just do it. Whatever it is that's getting in the way, be it fear or pride, just get over it and start a conversation, because it's not more important than that person in your life. You know, nurturing those relationships doesn't all have to be that difficult. The little things matter too. How about telling people you love them? I mean, can we do that? It's not that hard. It's not weird. Or how about give someone a hug if they need one? I think a lot of us need more of that in our lives. Or maybe there's something you really like or admire about someone. Just go tell them. I promise, doing the little things like these will be worth it. Making the lives of the people around you better will always reflect back on you. Bottom line is, don't focus so much on a goal that you don't spend time with the ones you love. Don't put everything into the future, because you can never predict what the future will bring. Instead, live a life worth living right now. Have some fun. And yes, you should definitely work hard. I hope every one of you chooses to shoot for the moon. Just don't forget to gaze at the stars. When you achieve your goals, which you will, don't be the one who says, "What now?" Have no regrets. Live a life where you can, when you achieve your goals, you can look forward and look back and be happy, because your life is full of the things that matter the most. Class of 2023, you are amazing. It's been an honor walking the halls with every single one of you. I wish you the best of luck. Go Hornets.
That was a great job, Carlos. Now we have a special tribute that will be performed by our Flower Bluff High School choir titled Promise. outstanding job to our choir. Thank you so much. The senior class of 2023 has accomplished many goals this year. We're fortunate to have a student body that works hard in extracurricular activities while also achieving academic success. This year's graduating seniors have been awarded a total of $2,268,100 in scholarships. I'd like to now present members of the senior class of 2023. As principal of Flower Bluff High School, I certify that these students have met all the requirements necessary to receive their high school diploma.
Members of the Board of Trustees, ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to certify the forthcoming students have completed the appropriate requirements as mandated by the Texas Education Agency and by policies of Flower Bluff Independent School District. The senior class of 2023 is ready to receive their diplomas.
Yes!
I will now ask Tamara Blair, High School Dean of Instruction, to begin awarding of diplomas. Please show respect for each student as he or she walks across the stage to help maintain the dignity of this great event. Thank you.
We will now announce students who have earned academic distinction. To be recognized as a graduate with academic distinction, the student must have an overall grade point average of 90 or above and be on an advanced graduation plan. This year, we have 192 students who have met this criteria. We will recognize the graduating class of 2023, beginning with our top 10 seniors in order of rank. Carlos Doble, valedictorian. Michaela Jordan, salutatorian. Henry Stanley. Lucas Dristudis. Suzanne Hall. Colleen Osgood. Lucas Bedio Perez. Andres Pereira. Julia Valesky. Anne Christabel Martin. Ms. Molly Parker and Ms. Tina Jones will continue with reading of seniors who are graduating with academic distinction. Students, please remain standing until all honor graduates have been announced.
Mason Agus. Nicholas Ames. Lane Atherton. Allison Baker. Joseph Balbin. Andrew Banks. Madison Bargansky. Kylie Batchen. Adair Bates. Carly Beadle. Courtney Beadle. Carter Blanchett. Ella Blanklinger. I'll get it. Isabella Burgess. Joshua Busby. James Cadena. Jordan Callahan. Kenneth Camry. Malaya Campbell. Eliana Canavacello. Sarah Candler. Avery Casanova. Karen Casper. Sophia Cervantes. Genevieve Chen. Hannah Chestnut. Isabella Centron. Jacob Cisneros. Ash Caldwell. Yeah. Dylan Cool. Morgan Daffron. Ethan Dansby. Christian Davies. Brandon Davila. Ireland Decker. Madison De Leon. You're okay. Mia De Leon. Jeffrey Diaz. Ava Durbin. Paige Dwyer. Addie Eichelberry. Wyatt Elwood. Elson Escamilla. Sophia Espinoza. Tyler Farley. Maria Favreau. Gabriel Fonts. Caitlin Frakes. Callie Freeman. Eliza Freeman. Joseph Fuller. Harley Gillespie. Agnes Garcia. Alyssa Garcia. Helena Garcia. Miranda Garcia. Wyatt Garcia. Darian Garrett. Bailey. Bailey Garza. Esteban Garza. Isabella Garza. Ismael Granados. Isabella Graves. Caleb Griffiths. Emily Gross. Katie Gross. Kaylee Guerrero. Emma Herenkohl. Peter Herrick. Lauren Hill. Sean Huang. Jeremiah Hooper. Cortland Howard. Natalie Hughes. Abigail Huell. Sierra Ingram. Henry Jansen. Emery Jeffers. Jasmine Jewell. Lucy Ann Johnson. Yeah. Samaya Johnson. Kaylee Jones. Serena Juarez. Alexis Kerfman. Caleb Knoll. Thomas Corsmo.
Nevaeh Lanter.
Yeah.
Christine Larden. Kyle Lawley. Delaney Laza. Lily Lazenby. Luke Lechner. Olivia Lee. Michaela Limmer. Israel Leslie. Jocelyn Lindley. Hey. Emily Long. Caitlin Lorenzi. Clayton Loy. Bella Louise. Sophia Lee. Christian Mader. Carson Mann. Jared Martin. Michael Martin. Diane Martinez Gutierrez. Jillian Martinez Gutierrez. Bailey Matthews. Megan Ma. Emily Mayo.
Go Bulldogs!
Brianna McCauley. Jalika McLean. Zoe McDonald. Maya Myrna. Kyler Meskey. Matthew Mesa. Jade Moreno. Nicholas Morris. Luke Minster. Madeline Mulder. Kaylin Nelson. Caleb O. Quinn O'Hagan Lopez. Madeline Oman. Michaela Palmer. Jennifer Pena.
Go, Jenny!
Juliana Pena. Isabella Perez. Lacey Perez. Lakin Pierce. Landon Pierce. Logan Pierce. Michelle Prince. Gina Shigoda. Yes, Gina. Alan Ramirez. Olivia Ramirez. Cooper Ray. Kyle Reed. Matthew Gochi Reyes. Caleb Reynolds. Woo! Mary Ritchie. Go Mary. Myla Roche. Gabrielle Rodriguez.
Go, Gabby.
Alexander Russell. Michael Sakalis. Oliver Sanchez Olivas. Nicholas Shear. Carson Schultz. Okay, it's okay. No worries. Krista Serrata Blaylock. Anya Savak. Grayson Siver. McKinley Smith. Connor Sneed. Catherine Speed. Mark Stadero. Isaac Stauffer. Lorelei Swank. Sierra Sylvester. Christian Tijerina. Loretto Tobias Jr.
Let's go, Loretto!
Dallas Torres.
Thank you so much.
Welcome, sweetie. You're welcome. Kayla Totter.
Let's go, Totter!
Aiden Tovar. Connor Tyler. Giselle Ungerman. Emily Vanderstein. Mila Van Maren. Woo! Jacqueline Vargas. Haley Villarreal. Ellie Visitu. Kira Volkman.
Hi, Mom. Hey, Dad. Hey, Bella.
What? Okay. Diego Wint. Abigail Wigginton.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the 2023 graduates with academic distinctions for their accomplishments. Honor graduates, you may be seated. We will now continue with our presentation of the class of 2023. These names will be read by Mrs. Shade Speed, Mrs. Audrina Underbrink, Mr. John Gain, and Ms. Lauren Smith.
Ready? Zoe Marie Fletcher. Anton South Hockmuller. Cheyenne Madison. Aber. Madeline Aber. Jada Acosta. Annabelle Acuna. Francisco Aguilar. Sarah Allen Padron. Micah Amador. Esperanza Ambriz. Aiden Anderson. Casey and Selmy. Jericho Arapak. No. No, he'll be right. No, he'll be right. You're Connor. Yeah. Connor Atwood. Isabella Ayala. James Byer. Jahai Bankston. Maisie Basham.
Worship card. But do you want Evelyn Trinity?
Evelyn Trinity Beard. Serenity Beasley. Wait.
It's Kaylin. Is that you?
No, it's not.
Oh,
Sydney Bell. Wesley Benham. Vivian Bentoncourt. Julie Bernal. David Berry. Martina Bazulka. Desiree Boatwright. Isaiah Botello. Joshua Brown. Shelby Buttram. Eliana Cabrera. William Carpenter. Jonathan Castillo. Andrea Castro. Mike Harvey Reyes Katmagan. Christopher Cheney. Paige Shafty. Estevan Chavarria. Margaret Kluge. Colette Concilio. Taj Crowley. Cadence Cudd.
Christian Catrayer. Jonathan Dansel. Cody Danley. Jaden Davila. Emery De La Paz. You're not. Joseph De Leon. Casey De Niro. Andrew Dominguez. Michaela Duffield. Jack Duke. Levi Edrington. Haley Escalante. Alexander Everett. Philippe Fairchild. Brett Allen Fergal. Daniel Fiallos. Joshua Flores. Cheyenne Flores.
Eli Flannoy. Ariana Garcia. Laura Garcia. Cameron Getman. Benjamin Gilbert. Glory Gilbert. Timothy Gilpin. That's it.
Mateo Gosi. Messiah Godinez. Angelique Gomez. Emma Gomez. John Gonzalez. Adam Grabowski. Caden Graham. Walter Graham. Corbin Griffin. Zitzara Guerra. Sean Guidry. Cameron Gwynn. Luis Gutierrez. Riley Hall. Melina Harris. Hunter Henny. Giselle Hernandez. Hector Hernandez. Kayla Hernandez. Mia Hernandez. Chevelle Hinojosa. Isabel Holland. Mark Hornsby. Thomas Hymas. Timothy Jenkins. Bradford Jennings. Grant Jennings.
Let's go, Grant!
Travis Lee Johnson Dunn. Avon Johnson. Aubrey Johnson. Haley Judd. Ty Ellen Kaler. Kristen Haley Kirk. William Cobus. Christopher Kuchenberger. Preston Lawrence. Samara Lerman. Benjamin Lopez. Gabriella Lopez. Gabrielle Lopez. Jacob Love.
What am I supposed to do with this?
Andres Lozano. Miguel Lee. Jonathan Chase Madlin. Jasper Mahar. Emma Manning. Angelica Maravilla. Summer Martin. Hunter Ashton Martinez. Jesus Martinez. Jose Martinez. Anthony Matlock. Kiana Celine McHugh. Thomas McCutcheon. Let's go, Eli McCamey. Elliot Mitchell McKee. Amanda McLemore. Colton McManus. Madison Mercer. Harley Miller. Angelina Minglana. Noah Mitchell.
Okay. No, you're good, Mike.
Talon Montefalcone. Luke Moore. Emily Morris. William Mulder. Peyton Myers. Patience Grace Orms. Hayden Ortiz. Jerrica Owens. Isaac Ozuna. Baron Panza. Connor Peel. Alexia Pena. Jonathan Pena. Josiah Pena. Raquel Perales Mahan. Natalie Perales. Nathaniel Pacetti. Isaac Pena. Jacob Poindexter. Jaden Polland. Tyler Porsche. Alexis Lynn Powell. Kiri Proya. Miles Pumala. Marcus Quinoneza. Adrian Quintero. Jacob Quiroga.
I've lost him. Yeah, I got you.
Jaden Ralston. Rihanna Ramos. Morgan Razor. Anissa Reddy. James Connor Reed. Rebecca Reeves. Estrella Reyna. Rocky Rich.
Sean Riojas. Ashley Roberts. Caitlin Roche. Grant Rockhold. Alejandro Rodriguez. Christopher Rodriguez Munoz. Margarito Rodriguez. Natalie Rodriguez. Romaldo Rosales. Valeria Ruiz. Julius Salazar. Vanessa Salazar. Damian Sanchez. Savannah Michelle Schaefer. Hannah Schell. Justin Schoenhoff. Jasmine Singh. Christian Serrano. Dylan Shaw. Rachel Ann Sheehan. Caden Sibley. Aiden Silvis. Eric Simmons. Samantha Cyrus. Jace Smalley. Connor Smith. Hector Solis. Zulma Soto. Shelby Spears. Jaden Stevens. Chase Stift. Lainey Still.
Can you announce me like a wrestler?
Caden Stry. Benjamin Tobin. Cesar Torres. Jared Torres. Matthew Torres. Nicholas Torres. Jacob Trevino. Oh. Joshua Trinidad Dutra. Matthew Turner. Claudia Vies. Marco Valdez. Yes, Arissa Valverde. Jeremiah Vanacek. Josiah Vasquez. Samantha Vasquez. Joel Vaughn. Madeline Veal. Catherine Vega. Isabella Vera. Dylan Wagoner. Kyan Wakefield. Jaden Walker. Elena Ward. Anna Washer. Hayden Webb. Kaysen Wells. Kaden Wells. Shiloh White. Braden Wimkin. John Wilhelm. Darius Williams. Robert Williamson. Hayden Wilson. Casey Work. Alexia Yarbrough. Isabella Ibanez. Erica Zarati. Aiden Jack Zavala.
I'd like to ask Andreas Beretta and Colleen Osgood to present the class farewell.
Andreas, what's my line again?
I don't know, man. I thought we were winging this.
I don't think that's a good idea.
This is why no one likes seashore kids. Good evening, everybody. If you don't know me already, my name is Andres Beretta.
And I'm Colleen Osgood.
And we would like to sincerely thank everyone for attending the Flower Bluff Class of 2023 graduation tonight.
Whoop, whoop. Yay!
Yes.
Yay.
Firstly, I'd like to ask my mom to stop crying. Thank you. Secondly, I'd like to emphasize how life-changing these past few hours and years have been for us.
It truly means so much that you are here with us today to support your friends, family, and class of 2023. Graduation can be chaotic and excruciating to sit through sometimes, but we really appreciate you all showing up tonight.
I'd like to start by thanking all of the patient observers and even more patient parents for painstakingly watching each child that you've never heard of cross the stage so you can take a video of your special little nugget for 12 seconds.
I think one of the most vital things to recognize is the impact of every single one of our guests here tonight. You were asked to come to our graduation because one of our fellow classmates, or their parents, wanted to be able to share this special moment with you.
To our parents, without your encouragement, understanding, stalking, occasional scolding, overwhelming presence, and suffocating protection, oh, and of course love, we wouldn't be on this stage tonight.
And to those who could not be here with us tonight, understand that you have had just as much of an impact on us as those who are.
Just as importantly, we would like to acknowledge every teacher, administrator, faculty member, and principal that we've had the pleasure of working with over the past 4 years.
All of you have helped us celebrate our accomplishments, reach our goals, and have offered a lifetime's worth of advice.
And we are beyond grateful for how you have shaped our lives and helped us mature into the young adults that we are today.
There's an extensive list of people who've shaped our education and overall well-being, all of which we'd like to thank individually.
However, Colleen and I are determined to leave this sweaty, crowded convention center as soon as humanly possible. So we must digress.
Andres and I are honored to be speaking in front of all of you and think it's quite fitting that we've been friends for so long and are graduating together tonight.
As some of you may know, Colleen and I have been friends for a whopping 15 years. Yup. I really dealt with her for that long.
Anyways, we attended Seashore until high school, and it was definitely eye-opening to go from such a small, close-knit school to the big family that Flower Bluff is.
Before we came here, Seashore seemed like the perfect level of education, with amazing administration and teachers that always had our backs.
And this is all completely true, but we didn't expect the warm welcome that we received from the students and faculty here at the high school.
Not only did Flower Bluff challenge us academically, but the well-cultivated environment, exceptional teachers, and incredibly supported student body helped us fit right in.
I guess you could say that regardless of where we came from, we were all able to find a home in the Bluff, and even more importantly, a home in the people that we met there.
Man, that's pretty good for winging it. Anyways, I'd like to congratulate you all one more time for this monumental mile mark that you've reached today. At this moment, it may feel like you have so much more treacherous schooling or toiling nights of work in order to accomplish your goals. But I'm here to comfort your mind and tell you that, well, you're right. It only gets harder. I'm very sorry. Harder? I hardly know her. Anyways, I cannot understate the importance of not only pursuing the future that you want for yourself, but also using the experiences that you have accumulated through these prosperous and experimental years of your life to guide you through this goofy, silly world we live in.
We know tonight feels like the end of an era for a lot of us. I'm sure we're all going to reminisce about the good memories we've all made this year and the past 4 years together. We got through a massive pandemic, multiple fires in the school building, and the regular hurdles of high school in general. But we did it all together, and class of 2023, we truly are the future. One of the best qualities I see in each of us is perseverance, and I hope you understand how valuable each one of you are to our community and to our world. Whether you're starting a job, attending college, or taking a break, please be proud of yourself. We've gone through so much and have conquered everything that's been thrown at us over the years. We've conquered like the Mongolian Empire, except we're not Mongolian, and it's not the 13th century, and our ruler isn't Genghis Khan, and...
Bubba, can we cut to the chase?
Okay. We may be at the end of our high school careers, but we have an entire world that's waiting for us. I think it's safe to say...
We made it.
Thank you.
This week is always a bittersweet week. We get to have many opportunities to attend different ceremonies, banquets, and we get to shake hands with a lot of you. I was able this week to be with our Flower Bluff Hornets, including our kindergarten students, the future graduating class of 2035. And while I was there, just like last year, they had a special message for their parents. And when we're there and we're watching them, we imagine you at that age. And I will tell you that they were pretty excited and happy. And it's that same excitement that I witnessed during your senior walk this week and here again tonight. Those little hornets had a message for their parents, and that day I felt it would be appropriate to share with you tonight. I hope that you will enjoy. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Class of 2023, please stand. Our graduation ceremony is a brief moment in our lives, but the memory of our time here at Flower Bluff High School will last forever. In a few seconds, we will count to three. the senior class of 2023 should boldly say Hornets, then move their tassel to the left. Ready? One, two, three, Hornets! Please remain standing for the benediction given by Suzanne Hall.
Please bow your heads and join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for safely bringing us all here to celebrate this milestone. We thank you for the friends, family, and teachers from kindergarten to senior year who have helped us to make it to this occasion. May we take the lessons learned both inside and outside the classroom to explore the many opportunities you have waiting for us. May we recognize the blessings you have given us and trust the plan you have set for each and every graduate. We ask that you help us to lead with love and kindness as we embark on the next chapter of our lives. And although we are moving on to an exciting time in our lives, remind us to slow down and appreciate the little things too. May you grant us strength and courage as we go our separate ways to chase our dreams. In your loving name we pray, amen.
Thank you, Barry. All right. Please join us one last time in the alma mater.
Thank you everyone for coming out tonight. Congratulations, seniors. When you leave, just remember you matter. Your life matters. You're here for a purpose. Class is dismissed.